I have heard the songs about the coal mines stripping mountainsides of beauty. Heard the songs of whales to make a marble statue weep. And I have wept to see the ice run crimson for the sake of human fashion. Heard the forests groaning as the axes cut them deep. But it never touched me deeper than the tears upon my face, and it never lasted longer than a day. Until that summer when I went back home to visit friends and family, and I saw what they had done to Charlesworth Bay. Now it's not the kind of place that ad men want to glorify in posters. Not the kind of place to set a greenie's heart alight. And I can't say that it filled my dreams or even held a special memory. But when I look back on my life, it's in my line of sight. And the cry that left my lips that day came not from conscious thinking. I had no chance to think of what to say. It was a grief so pure and deep that I cannot tell where it came from. When I saw what they had done to Charlesworth Bay. Now I have spent my holidays in hotels at the seaside. I have stood on sun-drenched balconies and breathed the salt sea mist. But not again shall I lie by some pool or stroll some private shoreline without wondering whose Charlesworth Bay was this. So now when I hear songs of coal mines or of forests gone forever or of city buildings sacrificed to feed the millionaires, I see again the giant shadow cast where once the marsh and swamp were. Feel again the rising anger and the bitter sting of tears. And you people who tear memories down and call it growth and progress, may you never know the grief I felt that day. For I have never felt so frightened for the future as that morning when I saw what they had done to Charlesworth Bay. Oh, just look at what they've done to Charlesworth Bay.